Hi guys! Welcome back to this channel. This is Alex Balingit, founder and creator of Trading Circle. And sa video na to, pag-uusapan natin ang how to overcome fears in trading. So, una, define muna natin yung fear. Ano ba yung fear at bakit tayo nagkakaroon ng fear as a person? So, from its definition, we refer to our emotional response to something that appears harmful as being in fear. So, nagkakaroon tayo ng fear or ng takot kapag alam natin na subject tayo for harm. Kapag, halimbawa, harm. Ibig sabihin, masasaktan tayo, magkakaroon. Ang harm kasi hindi lang naman physical eh. Alam mo yung harm na there will something be taken away from you. So, doon nagkakaroon ng harm, di ba? Yung nagkakaroon ka, subject for threat. Kapag halimbawa, nasa-threatened ka, yun, nagkakaroon tayo ng fear. So, many traders suffer with this feeling and fear might prevent you from using the skills you've worked hard so to acquire. So, ang sad truth niyan is, kapag kahit sobrang galing mo as a trader and you've worked hard for that skill to be achieved, hindi mo ma-execute ng tama yung skill mo as a trader. Kasi nga, pangungunahan ka ng fear. Ihihinder ka nung fear na yon. So, unang fear dito, yung fear of the unknown. Traders are excited on winning big without knowing how much they are risking. So, fear of the unknown. Hindi mo alam kung ano mangyayari. Hindi mo alam kung ano yung ginagawa mo. Mostly yung mga traders dito, excited na, okay, pag nag-invest ako, ayan na, malaki na yung kikitain ko kasi natuto na ako, may napanood akong video, may napanood akong strategy, gumagana daw siya. Newbies po kasi ang specially na biktima ng mga ganitong fear. Encounter this especially when shifting from demo account to live account. Most often than not kasi what they do is, for example, they tried paper, virtual or demo account. They are profitable in 3 months. Then when they shifted from a demo to live account, doon na mangyayari yung fear of the unknown. Doon na mabablanko sila lahat. After nung pinractice nila, wala na. Hindi na nila alam yung gagawin nila. Kasi that's where emotions come in their trading skills. So it hinders na pagdating doon. Kasi nga, takot na sila. Hindi na nila alam. Especially money na kasi yung pinag-uusapan eh. There is involvement of real and true money. And you know what? When you have attachment with money, when you invested it in something that is risky, you look into that possibility na pwede itong mawala anytime, yung pinaghirapan ko, pwedeng mag-vanish, pwedeng matalo, di ba? So, to overcome this fear, traders should do risk management and enroll to trading courses. So, para mawala kasi yung fear of the unknown na to, when we say unknown, it's something that we don't know, di ba? It's something that we are not prepared for. Kasi unknown siya sa atin. It's like, you are in a dark cave. You're walking in a dark cave where you don't know where this path leads you on. So, kung makikita nyo dito sa picture, I put an example here, it's full of question mark with a dark road. Tapos overlapping yung mga pathway niya. Di ba? Ang gulo-gulo, unknown. You don't know where, are you going to go right? Are you going to go left? Or are you heading this direction? So, there are lots of questions in your mind. So, sa fear of the unknown, to overcome this, kailangan mo ng extreme and intensive risk management and you have to enroll to trading courses. I'm not saying na requisite talaga ang trading courses, but it can significantly and guarantee na matutulungan ka when it comes to fighting these fears. Why? Kasi trading courses help you, it provides you with ladderized and systematic way on how to approach and attack the market. It will give you that knowledge na kailangan mo ng dire-direcho, di ba? Nung hindi overlapping. So, hindi ka matatrap dyan sa fear of the unknown. Pangalawa is fear of being wrong. We are afraid of being wrong, especially in trading. Natural, sino ba ang takot na hindi magkamali, 'di ba? Takot naman kasi tayo magkamali. Meron it as a human, 'di ba? Kung may gagawin ka, halimbawa, especially ang naka-risk diyan is buhay mo, health mo, pera mo. Yan, takot ka talaga kasi pag nagkamali ka, halimbawa, mawawala yung pera mo. Pag nagkamali ka, mako-compromise yung health mo. Pag nagkamali ka, mawawala yung buhay mo. Halimbawa, 'di ba? Ganun. Kaya we are afraid of being wrong. We don't want to be wrong kasi we always connotate or correlate wrong as something that will result in a harm or negative situation for us in the future. So it hurts our ego and affects our trading psychology. Kasi kapag takot kang magkamali, natural, ma-hurt yung ego mo as a trader kasi you dictated in your mind, I practice myself enough, I am ready for a live account, I have already acquired the skills that I need. Then, na nagkamali ka, you already gaslighted yourself. Ah, I'm not enough pa pala. Kulang pa pala yung skills ko. Always remember that Forex is a game of probability. So, it's okay to commit wrong. Okay, it's okay to be wrong. It's okay to commit mistakes. It's not a problem at all when it comes to Forex. Lagi ko nga sinasabi, when you are in a trading industry, being wrong is always okay. Kasi you can never be right against the market. Si market ang masusunod, hindi ikaw. Ikaw ang magkakamali against kay market. But the market doesn't care about whether your analysis should be respected or not. Walang pakialam si market dyan. So, yung fear of being wrong, wala, hindi makakatulong yan sa trading mo. It will actually hinder and slows down your progress. Then, fear of missing out. In trading, we experience of missing our trades due to some factors like being away from our setup. Eto, halimbawa, kapag pumunta ka sa trabaho, nalayo ka lang sa trade mo, and then halimbawa, during the morning, you already spot a good setup, and then pagpasok mo ng work mo, kailangan habulin ko yung trade na yon, then enter, kailangan ganito, may malaking opportunity doon. Nagkakaroon kasi tayo ng FOMO or fear of missing out when we saw an opportunity and we hardly want to let go of that opportunity. Kumbaga may greed na nasa puso mo na, I have to grab this opportunity, I need this great reward. You don't want to miss it out. Ganon, parang you're treating that reward as once in a lifetime na marireceive mo. So, dun ka nagkakaroon ng FOMO kasi it leads you in violating your own trading rules. We tend to chase the move in the market even though it is against our plan. So, kasi just because na wag siyang ma-let go, hindi baling hindi na masunod yung trading plan mo. So, maling-mali po yun. So, para malabanan yung fear of missing out, there is what we call pending orders. Set up an alert and order when the price is near your entry. May mga pending orders po tayo. May buy limit, sell limit, buy stop, sell stop. Meron tayong automatic trailing stop. Meron tayong manual na stop loss. Meron tayong manual na take profit. All of these things exist in Forex trading. And you know what? There's nothing to worry about fear of missing out. Kasi there's a solution for that if you just know the pending order. Sa video na to, hindi ko na siya kayang i-elaborate kasi mas hahaba siya and we're just talking about fear here. So sa next na video, gagawan ko siya about pending orders kung paano siya magagamit laban kay fear of missing out. Pero yun, in gist, kayang labanan yung missing out na to. Kasi yung pending orders, halimbawa, umaga, nakakita ka ng opportunity. So on this price, kailangan mag-enter ako. Hindi mo na kailangan ma-FOMO kasi there is an automated na way to do it na pag nag-hit yung price na to, automatically yung trade mo mag-enter. There's a way to do that. Okay? And then lastly, fear of losses. Ito yung takot kang matalo. When this fear strikes you, it can lead to missing a good trade. Ito yung kapag takot ka matalo. For example, ito sabi dito, you decide to close the trade even though you have set a stop loss. Halimbawa, may set ka na, may take profit, may stop loss, nagra-run na yung trade mo, and then konti pa lang bumababa siya sa stop loss. Halimbawa, yan, from the entry level, bumababa ng konti sa stop loss. Ang ginawa mo, naglo-loss ka na ng konti pa lang, pero malayo siya, malayo pa siya from your actual stop loss, in-exit mo na agad yung trade mo. So, this led you to missing a good trade. So, what happens to you? What if after closing that trade and exiting it, just because you are afraid to lose, biglang nag-go siya into your direction? So, what would you feel? Sayang, dapat pala in-enter ko na, hinayaan ko na lang mag-play out and mag-run out yung trade na to. But, that's a hindsight. Hindi mo na mababalik yun kasi close mo na yung trade mo. So, para malabanan yung fear of losses, trade with only the money you can afford to lose. Lagi ko naman sinasabi sa inyo yan. Ahead of entering this trade, are you willing to let go of that money? If yes, then go hit that buy or sell button. Accept that there is no 100% in Forex. So, there's no point of fearing losses kasi trading is always correlated with the word losses. Kasi kung may profit, may losses. Diba parang sa buhay lang yan. There are only two options in life. It's either yes or no, right or wrong, or death or life. Diba? Ganun lang naman yan. So, win or lose, profits or losses. So, hindi pwedeng puro profit ka, hindi pwedeng puro nasa life ka, hindi pwedeng puro nasa right ka. Diba? You get what I mean? So, if you want to be successful in trading, you always have to be prepared to get lost. Okay? So, Forex is a game of probability. Always remember that. And there is no point of worrying about these fears because it will just hinder you from executing that long-time planned skills or yung mga skills nyo na na-practice over time. So, there's no point of worrying about that. So, kung may mga thoughts ka, ano ba yung mga fears mo dito na ngayon, alam mo na yung solution? Meron ka bang natutunan? So, leave a comment nga kung meron nga or like kung may natutunan ka. And then, subscribe ka na rin sa channel ko kung bago ka dito and hit that notification bell button para ma-notify ka sa mga susunod na content ko. See you sa next na video.